sacrifice of reconciliation.
Of the Son and of
the Lord be with you.
And other people began to join them, knowing that God is.
On the waters, making them the wellspring of the Holy Spirit.
Good morning. This week, in my column, I write about what happened last weekend here in the parish and how a lot goes on behind the scenes that we don't see. And we have a little bit more of that going on today. We're pleased to welcome back Father Art and wish him all the best. But if you saw, I don't want to call it the ball game, but the Brewers were on TV yesterday. And you saw some interviews with Bob Uecker, and you know how he's recovering from his heart surgery, and Father Art is still recovering from his heart procedure. And you know, Uecker wanted to get back in the box there, but I think he's kind of like the Brewers pitching. He wouldn't last five innings either, you know? So, you know, you got that desire. Well, Father Art needs to conserve his strength a little bit today because he has the next Mass and he has three baptisms there, and you know how he likes to put everything into those baptisms. So, Deacon Bob, or Mike Rooney was supposed to preach today. He's under the weather, and so I get called up off the bench. All right, so here we go. All right. But to help Father Art a little bit, I have a question that's related to the readings for today and today's feast day. You know what happens when Prince Fielder gets up there and he gets one right in the wheelhouse, right? And you can hear the crack of that bat. And you know that ball's going. And it's going up, you know, it's going way up there. And what's Uecker's signature statement about that? What does he say altogether? Get up. Get out of here. Gone. Right? Okay. I didn't hear it from the back there. I don't know. Well, that's because you're always watching on TV and never listening to the radio. That's why. All right. You know, sometimes I think that signature statement of Uecker's is what we think about in today's feast day. Today, the Feast of the Ascension. It's got to get up, get out of here, gone. And we think that's what happened to Jesus. You know, we kind of say, oh, gone. You know, that's kind of our image of the ascension. But if we listen carefully to the readings today, that's not really true. Because as we heard in that first reading from Acts, apostles are looking up there like that. They got this kink in the neck. And two men come next to them. Two messengers come and say, what are you guys looking up in the sky for? What are you standing here for? Get to work. There's stuff to be done. And that Jesus, who has been taken up from you, will return in the same way that he left. And the scripture language that is used for Jesus' leaving is that he was in a cloud. And a cloud is always an image of God embracing people. That's the biblical image for God embracing people. That came in Exodus. That was the presence of God. So Jesus has gone back to the Father, in some way is embraced by God, and yet the disciples are looking up. That's not necessarily the way that he went. Perhaps he didn't go up, but he went this way. So it's not just get up, but it's look out if we are to look for the presence of the Lord. In the gospel today, Luke's account of the ascension, as he ends his gospel, he captures the ascension as happening almost at the end of the day of Easter. That whole chapter 24 is all one event. Everything happens on that day. And the final part of that day, as they get into late at night or early in the next morning, is the ascension, is the movement of Christ. It's tied into the resurrection. And finally, Jesus seems to have spent all night talking to the disciples, and they maybe got it in their heads and understand what is going on, maybe. And as Luke begins his second volume, the Acts of the Apostles, he uses a little different language to describe what is happening. He uses the biblical code word 40. He said, for 40 days, Jesus met with his disciples and had many appearances and talked to them a lot about what was going on. 40 is biblical code language for transition. We have 40 years in the desert for the Exodus event. Was it exactly 40 flips of the calendar? Might have been, but we don't know. It rained for 40 days and 40 nights. Was Ark? Was it actually 40 X's on the calendar? Maybe, but maybe not. It's biblical code language for a time of transition, for a time of moving from one event to the next, some kind of transformation that's going to take place. And so in Acts, when Luke says for 40 days that Jesus was on earth and explaining things to his disciples, doesn't necessarily mean 40 X's on the calendar. What it means is a time of transition.